Hello dear students, and welcome back in our biology session. So in our previous video we have discussed about the certain changes which are happens at the puberty. Okay, so in that we have discussed the last point, that is the secretion which are produced by or secreted by the sweat gland or the sebaceous gland. Because of that the adolescents are having the acne or the pimples. But there are the so many different glands are present in our body. There are the certain glands which are having the duct. So we can say that they are having the pipeline structure, and with the help of their pipeline structures, they are secreted their secretions into the particular body parts. Okay, the glands which are having the ducts like that, we can say oil glands, sweat glands, and the salivary glands are having the ducts, and with the help of that ducts, they are secreted their secretion in that particular body organ. Okay, but on the other hand, there are the certain glands, they are don't have this duct, they are secretion, or their secretion they directly added or they directly release into the bloodstream, and that is the reason that glands are called as what? That is the reason that glands are called as ductless glands, or also it is called as endocrine glands. Okay, and the endocrine glands are examples. We can say that the pituitary gland is there. So now we will move for the same point, in that we will discuss the next change at the puberty, that is what? Development of sex organs. Okay, so in our previous lesson we have discussed about the male and the female reproductive system or reproductive organs. So at the age of the puberty, there is a development of the sex organs starting to happen. Okay, so in the boys, the testes and the penis get developed. Also, they started to secrete the sperms, or they started to produce, their reproductive organs started to produce the sex gamete, that is what? Sperms. While in the girls, the sex organs is get developed, that is what? Ovaries. Okay, so the ovaries started to get mature, and they also started to produce the sex gamete, that is what? Ova. Okay, so it is what? At the age of the puberty, there is a development of the sex organs is also takes place. Now we'll see the next point, that is what? Reaching mental, intellectual and emotional maturity. Okay, so this puberty period is a very important period, because adolescent period or this puberty period is also the one of the most important period in the lifespan of a human being, because during this puberty or during this adolescence period, whatever the way of the thinking of the persons is also changed. Okay, in this stage the adolescents become more independent than they are before. Also very important, that they are very self-conscious. They are trying to thinking about themselves. They are thinking about their future, or in short, we can say they started to think about themselves deeply. In that, we can say that in fact, this puberty or this adolescence period is the period in that the adolescent's brain is having the greatest capacity for the learning. So during this puberty, there are so many changes that happens in our body. So sometimes the boys and the girls are having the insecurity, or they are feeling the shy on their body. Okay, because there are so many changes that happens in our body. But it is very difficult for the adolescent to adjust with the body changes. Okay, but my dear students, it is very important to tell you that there is no need to insecure about your physical changes. Okay, you should take care of your body, and you have to keep in your mind that what these all the changes are the natural changes which are takes place in your body. Okay, so this is the next change that we have seen during the puberty, that is what? The reaching the mental, intellectual and the emotional maturity. Okay, so now you are also the teenager, mind you are also having different changes in your body, and you are also thinking about yourself. You are also having some emotional changes and the mental changes or the intellectual changes. Okay, so this is all about the changes which takes place during the puberty period. Now we'll move on the next point, that is what? Secondary sexual characters. Okay, what is mean by secondary sexual characters? So in our first lesson, or in our previous lesson, that is what? Reproduction in animals, we have discussed about the male and the female reproductive system. In that we have discussed about the male and the female reproductive organs also. And just now also we have said that at the age of the puberty, the development of the sex organs happens. Okay, so the sex organs are get developed, and in both girls, they started to produce the sex gametes. That we can say that in the male, the sex gamete is what? Sperms. While in the female, the sex gamete is what? Egg or ova. Okay, we can say that. So, the sex organs, like in the boys, we can say that the testes and the penis are mature and they produce the sperms. Okay, while in the girls, the sex organs are also developed, that is what? Ovaries, and the ovaries started to produce the eggs or the ova, and also the ovaries is get mature and release the mature eggs. Okay, but with the help of these changes, there are the different changes that happens in the boys and the girls. If we talk about the boys, these changes, the development of the sex organs and the production of the male gametes is done. But with the help of that, in the boys, we can say that the boys are having the hairs on their face, or we can say that facial hairs are there. Also, we can say the boys are having the mustache or the beard. Okay. And if we talk about the girls, then the girls are having the increase in the size of the breast. So, all these are the features which helps to distinguish between the male and the female. And that characters which helps to distinguish between the males and the females, that characters are called as secondary sexual characters. Okay, secondary sexual characters. So, the development of the sex organs or the production of the reproductive gametes are there only, but along with them, there are the certain changes happens in your body, and the characters or the features helps to distinguish among the male and the female, and that characters are called as secondary sexual characters. Okay, so here we can say that if the beard or the mustache is there, then obviously that person will be what? Male. Okay, and if there is an increase in the breast size, then we can say that this is the female. Okay, so these are the certain characters which helps to distinguish between the male and the female, and that characters are called as secondary sexual characters. Also, we can say the boys are started to develop the hairs on the chest. In both the girls and the boys, the hairs under the arms or hairs above the thigh area and in the pubic regions, hair is started to grow. Okay, so all these changes happens during the puberty period. Okay, or during the adolescence period. Up till now, we have seen that there are the certain changes happens in the adolescents. Okay, but have you ever seen why these changes happens, or because of which things the changes, all these changes happens in the body of the adolescent? So all these changes at the onset of the puberty change happens in the adolescents, and the thing or that thing because of what? So all these changes happen, that is what? Hormones. Okay, because of the hormones. So these hormones play a vital role in during the changes of the puberty. Whatever the changes happens in the girls and the boys during the puberty, all that changes takes place because of these hormones. Okay, and these hormones are the chemical substances which brings the different changes in the human body. Or we can say that these are the hormones, these are the secretions from the endocrine gland. Okay, so in this previous point we have discussed about endocrine gland is what? The glands which directly release their secretion into the blood stream. That glands are called as what? Endocrine gland or Duchenne's glands. Okay, so yeah, all these hormones, so because of these hormones, different changes takes place at the puberty in the boys and the girls. If we'll talk about the boys, then the hormones, that is what? The male sex hormones, that is testosterone. Okay, so in the male sex hormone, that is what? Testosterone started to secreted by the testes, which bring the different changes in the boys. We can say that the mustache is there, beard is there. Okay, so all these changes happens in the male because of the hormone. And what is the name of that hormone? That is what? Testosterone hormone, which is secreted by the testes. Okay, while in the girls, there are the certain changes happens in the girls, and that is because of the hormone, that is, we can say that female sex hormone. So if we talk about the girls, once the puberty is reached, then the ovary started to produce the female sex hormones, that is, we are calling as what? Estrogen. And this estrogen is responsible for the different changes which are takes place in the girl's body. We can say that what is increasing the breast size. So all these changes takes place in the girls because of the progesterone hormone. Okay. Once the girls reach at the age of the maturity, then the ovaries become ready for the reproduction, and also the ovaries started to secrete the female sex hormone, that is what estrogen. Estrogen is responsible for the further changes in the girl's body. For example, we can say that what increase in the breast size. Okay, so because of the different hormones in the male and the female, all these the body changes is takes place in the both girls and the boys. Okay, so the production of these hormones is also under the control of the one of the another hormone which is secreted by the pituitary gland. Okay, so the production of the sex hormones is the under the control of the another hormone, and that hormone is get secreted by the pituitary gland. Okay, so this is all about what secondary sexual characters. What is meant by the secondary sexual character? These are the certain features which helps to distinguish the male and the female. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the development of sex organs. Also we have discussed about the reaching the mental, intellectual, emotional maturity, and also we have discussed about the secondary sexual characters. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We will meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.